July 67. That was my final year in secondary school when the war started. So the school had to close when we heard that the war had started. So the school closed. Everybody went home. I came back home. And not too long after, we started hearing bombing going on. And people were saying, ah, federal troops have arrived, federal troops have arrived. Before then, there was an incursion from Biafra. There's a bridge linking two places. So we just crossed the bridge overnight and drove in a convoy to Benin to cover the government in Benin. Some of them proceeded towards Ore. They were going to capture Lagos. They couldn't go far. They got as far as Okitipupa and they were stopped. Then those that stopped in Benin set up the military administration and called the place Republic of Benin. That was for the whole Midwest region at that time. But there was no peace, really, because everybody was scared. Not long after they set up the government, we heard that they had been chased out of Benin. And there were the federal troops, and they were now heading down this way. So there was panic. Next, we knew they were at Agbo. Within a day, they were in Iseruku. And just one day like this, we started hearing boom, boom, boom. The bombs were landing inside us. People were running helter-skelter. Nobody knew exactly where to go. My family, we were like 12 in our house. We decided that nobody was going to run to anywhere. We'll stay in the house and face whatever will happen. And as night was falling, somebody, one member of the family, felt that if we stayed in the house like that, we could break the door and just shoot anybody they find. So said we should open the trap door in the ceiling. And all of us went up, all 12 of us went up into the ceiling, covered the trap door. But then the soldiers did not come into the house that night. The fear was, what if a bomb landed on the roof? Where would we be? You know? So, but nothing like that happened. In the morning, we just heard gunshots. One gruffy voice. Who did hear come out before I shoot? And we were still up there. We decided to come down. Before we even came down, they had kicked the door open and started ransacking the house before they now came to the room where we were gathered. And we all raised our hands. Said we should all come out, came out. They marched us to the field. Wait. Well, of course, as we were marching, they were picking the young women who are raped. They just point at you, come. Whatever they wanted to let you go. So, I had six of my sisters. except one. It was quite small. Yes, I can be ripped. But that was the small part of it. We marched to the field, and the commander asked all of us to sit on the grass. We sat. And after a while, the, let me call them overzealous soldiers, started picking young men. Pick, you come, follow them. Go behind the police barrack. Next thing you hear is, you shoot them. We're all sitting there in fear. Until later, another commander came in. He rebuked those ones and said, women and children should go home. So, me, I joined the women and children. I went home. But my father and my elder brother stayed back. And among them there, we decided that, okay, they heard that there was something like a welcoming party for the soldiers. So the people sitting there decided on their own to go and join the welcoming party. So they left that place. My father and my senior brother decided that they were not going to join. They would rather come home. So they came home. But there was still no peace. The shootings were still going on. Biafrans were still shelling the town. And I just told my father that I cannot stay here. My place is close to the river. So once they shell from Onitsha, land in that vicinity, I told him I couldn't stay there anymore. So he was angry, he said I should go wherever I wanted. So I came into town, stayed with one of my friends. But they were still picking on young men. They will look at you somehow and feel like this person must have been a Biafran soldier. And they will pick you. Nobody will know what happened to you. So, meanwhile, some of us have started making friends with the Nigerian soldiers. Until one of them, who was our friend, a friend, a lieutenant, advised us to find our way out of Asaba. So, three of us said, how do we needed passes to get out of Asaba. We needed to get a pass from the military authorities. We couldn't get this pass. We tried for a week, we couldn't. Until somebody now said, okay, the lieutenant said, okay, just pack books in a bag. Get on the road. They ask you, say you are a student, show them books, they are going back to school. So that was how we escaped from Asaba.